Ahoy hoy!
Ahoy hoy!
Ahoy hoy hoy!
He's not Straw.
And he is Parker.
And together we are. Oh yeah, it's him as well.
I'm here. Now today we have been...
Where's me head?
Bloody hell, me head's gone!
You sort
of... Yes, hear it!
Today we've been joined by a special guest.
Indeed.
My dog. Hello, Frankie. It's the one. It's the only. It's Parker.
No. Paul Sutton. Look at him over there.
There he is. Oh, the man himself.
AKA the real cat lad on Twitter. I don't know what you are on other medias.
Just normal cat lad.
Just normal cat lad. You're not
Someone
real.
Stole the cat lad on Twitter already.
Ah, bastard.
One bastard.
Yeah, so they had to be
apparently
real.
They've done one whole post.
Oh, kill him!
Years ago, so it was stolen from me, so yes.
Hunt them down and kill them!
That was like, I don't know if anyone here knows Screen Junkies website, they do various things. They've got a fella called John Bailey, who's a voice-over artist, and he's Epic Voice Guy, and he's Epic Voice Guy and everything, but he's not Epic Voice, for ages he wasn't Epic Voice Guy on Twitter, because someone already had it. And it's like, oh, gutted.
Yeah, I do watch a lot of Screen Junkies.
I enjoy it a lot.
So, what are you playing today?
Guild Ball!
Never heard of
Love it. Well, you're a
It looks like a silly game.
It's a good game.
I don't know how to play Wrath of Kings, so...
So, Guild Ball
right.
is...
Nor do we!
No, that's true. As you will notice.
As is blinding me on the ears!
What team have you got?
I've got my Morticians.
Nice. What's your lineup?
With Obelus, obviously. Probably stay in my team long after Scalpel's been gone because he's just
yeah, I'm hearing
dirty,
that.
Dirty,
that's exactly what I'd do.
He's brought his little bird and his other little bird, Cossets.
Mm-hmm.
We've got Bonesaw in there, I've been using him a couple of times, so I want to try him out. Obviously, Silence because of his immense amount of influence, and Mist because I'm a bit dirty like that.
Yep.
And 15 influence. This is the Fishbones team that I stole off someone off the forum whose name I can't remember. But thanks for that. I will blatantly steal that name. And I think they do really well as a footballing team. So hopefully I'll get to prove that and not get my arse handed to me.
Indeed.
On film.
On film!
I'm bringing the Alchemists. I've got Midas and Flask, Kel Surprise, Mercury, Vitriol, Calculus and Compound. Because I quite like Compound. He's not just... Well, he is a goalie, but he's not just a goalie. He is, I think, good at other things. He's got plenty of pushes, and he's got a lovely tackle push on two. Two-inch melee, so it's just like, oh, I've got the ball, bye! And I love that. If I can pull it off, which I probably won't. Yeah.
Although I will be trying to score, so I'll give you plenty of opportunities to try and stop scoring.
We can only hope.
Because it's not the best fighty team in the world.
Yeah. A bit.
So we'll see. We'll see how
we will see. So I believe it was me to activate first, was it not?
It is. Silence has managed to kick the ball behind a building.
Yep, which is not good for me. But also, it might not be good for you. We'll see, I guess. So I think I will begin at the beginning with Midas, because...
Dun-dun-dun!
Why the fudge? Why the toffee fudge not, eh? So I think he will go for and move.
Dun-dun-dun!
He's ranting.
Sprinting.
He might, I don't know, yeah. Yeah, I think he's going to have to sprint,
come
isn't
in.
He?
Come here.
So he's got a sprinting of eight, so that is.
Hello, little doggy.
That far.
Hello, sweetheart. Ow, that's nymphs. Don't
nip. See, what can I do? What can I do?
You're just a TV whore, aren't you?
I could move around and snap. Yeah. If I do that, then you will just nom 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 the ball from me with your magical powers.
Nom nom nom.
And then if I don't have the ball, then you'll get the ball. So I think...
Get the ball.
Get the ball. So I'm going to move to there with the five. And then there with the three. Making me eight. It should put me an inch in to snap the ball too.
Yeah, would have been if I had moved the ball, yeah.
Which I will do. But then I think I'm immediately going to let the ball go.
Oh, you dirty!
And I can leave it an inch. So so I can just drop it about there.
That's just rude.
Isn't that rude and nasty? Yes, it is.
He's a guest, and you're treating him like that.
So I've spent one point...
I'll have my ball back.
Take your ball back and I'm going home!
You're Mr. Enjoying my ball back.
Exactly where I am, or how to escape.
He's in our dungeon now!
Remember, listen for the safe word.
Yeah.
Banana!
No, plushie.
You'll be getting insulted on.
I don't care. I want a flask plushie. I desperately think that would be amazing if there was a flask plushie. I would buy the fuck out of that.
It'd be definitely better than the remote control one.
Yeah.
Oh, remote control would be good though. Anyway, so 5 points to steal.
Shut out's
the one that makes you go last.
Shut out goes last.
So I'll have that.
Confidently.
Yoink.
And Tux is the one that. You have to go next, doesn't
it? Yeah. But I need five, don't I? Because he's a bit of a dick. I did not get any!
He's a bit of a dick.
And the shitty dice rolling has started, and it's not me for a change. Whoop, whoop, whoop!
Then what I should have done is not drop the ball. Because now I can't pass it, because I've already dropped it. Although I suppose I can snap it and then pass it.
Left.
I've got 1 point left, so I could snap the ball and then pass it.
Again, though, because you've dropped it. Can you drop it and then pick it up again?
I don't see why not. But I'm not going to, because fuck the world.
just out of pure spite.
Just out of fucking spite, you bastards.
Oh, that one's going to get mentioned in the crossbox, isn't it?
I'm going to try and heavy burden silence, needing a five, mm-hmm. with my no momentum. So I need a five on one dice. Ta-da!
Hey, oh, I can do that.
That's good.
Can't do
them
five dice.
Yeah, that's it. It's difficult, isn't it? Oh well, that's Levi. That's my activation. Activated.
That's -4, -4. Is it?
And -4, -4, and then -2 character plays.
Right.
We always get confused between that and blind because they're the same but different.
Yeah, but one. Yeah, that's attacked.
Same but different.
Well, they are.
Well, they're different then, aren't they?
Oh, penis off.
He's brave enough to try and get that ball. So I'm gonna have to stand up. I don't see this happening a lot.
No, we don't. We're too bloody lazy.
Yeah. You think we'll stand up when I'm carrying this around?
Another 9 months you might be able to. Might come out by then.
Now I've just got visions of me carrying around this big baby poo. Like a big old poo, like a baby.
Science isn't fast enough at the best of times, is it?
Wouldn't be a baby though, would we?
Alright, Mist would definitely be putting himself...
Oh, he'd be
what's
well in trouble.
What's compounds... Charging is 6 inches.
Six. If you end up within six, I can charge.
What's his melee range?
Two.
Ooh, he's a dirtbag.
But if you're there, then I can't do it.
Yeah, then I can probably do it now. Right, so Mist is probably going to get battered. But hey, he's a union.
Incoming!
So, you might have to really go. Way to go, four.
Frankie!
Oh, what are you doing, Dave?
Oh, yeah!
Frankie, come here!
I thought it was these two I had to worry about.
No, no.
Frankie! Oi!
Good job we're not playing on the clock, isn't it?
Frankie, yeah. Come here!
I forget.
Come here! Come on! What's this? Oh, what's this? Come here, you little shit!
We have one special guest and then almost raped by the dog.
Come here! Come here! What's this?
The video is no longer safe for work.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello. Right, anyway, so.
Put on!
Just try to distract me.
Come here.
So, way to go, for one.
Yep.
Come here. Come lay down.
Don't
snort at me,
you
little bugger.
Two, three, snap.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll try and pass back to silence.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so we are
out. Uh-huh. So what, there's that -1 dice, isn't it? Oh, but you've succeeded.
Ooh.
You suck all of the seed. Mmm, delicious seed. Oh, that sounded a bit weird.
That sounded really good.
Quite momentum, and we will use that.
Oh, so it is give and go. Yeah, we always get confused which one's which.
No.
See, well, I can never remember which one. I don't know. I'll never know. And I almost don't now look it up because I don't want to know. I want to not know.
So he'll dodge and...
Yeah. Well, screw you.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Well.
Ah.
Well, that's a bugger.
Madge.
I'm sure I'm going to do it now.
Right. Silence has still never scored, so he's going for his first ever goal at some point.
Has he scored with you?
Nah.
Never got that far off the ball, didn't he?
Nah.
I got him there once, I think he got tackled or something.
Is Tretton going to do as the veteran player then for Morticians?
I kind of don't want it to be Cosset. I like Cosset as she is. I think if we make her a veteran, I'll be torn between which one to take. I'd like to see veteran Graves. It's just basically Graves with two influence. And an easier side than Brogue.
Yeah. And you can't really have, in my mind, you can't really have veteran Silence until he becomes the captain in season 3 or 4 or whenever. I was very surprised that they had veteran Brisket. I was really expecting it to be Boiler. I guess they'll do him
he's too young.
Yeah.
Veteran Silence could just be a dead model where Obelus finds out he's trying to become captain and kills him.
Yeah, there is that. There is that.
Veteran Mist, he's practically a Mortician's player.
Lol.
Yeah. I still use
just
him.
Just put him in.
Yeah.
Put him in the Morticians. He deserts the Union. Just come join us.
Okay, I'm going to activate Flask.
Oh, friend.
He's going to do a little smoke poop underneath himself. And then, in honour of WCWW, who may or may not be watching.
Well, not at the moment, they're not.
That's just really odd.
It's scary. That means there's video cameras in here. Apart from that one.
Well, no, this is it. This was the discussion they were having. There were some people who think that he should sound like...
the mouse droid. Tweaky.
Tweaky, yeah. And he said then there's other wrong people who think he sounds like a mouse droid.
I don't think he sounds like either. I just can't imagine him sounding like Tweaky, really.
There was a nice thing, I think it was... wrong now. I think it was, they would say that Chris Hay said it should sound like a posh bloke, like a butler. Mm. Your vials of fire, sir!
I kind of go with that.
Kind of C-3PO, posh butler kind of sound.
C-3PO trapped in R2's body.
I'm sure he was once, if you know what I mean.
Hey!
Nothing with a bit of droid on droid action.
Dirty droid.
They are technically speaking genderless.
He's got to be called Golden Love for some reason.
Yeah.
Frankie.
Well, actually, I'm not going to stand up because that seems a really dangerous invitation.
Frankie, come here.
Sitting down.
Wait, come right. here.
Standing up, bending over a table. Ooh, sir. Suits you, sir.
Oh, dear. Right. Okay. See, now that part of the plan went really well, and now.
Now you don't know what to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
She's a handy WCWW implement.
Oh, I know, right? Boom. I can only charge you if you get within 6, though. So if you were to get in,
no, I'm just seeing it.
Lure me!
I shall kill you.
Not literally. I don't really want to lure
you. That was a fucking.
I think of all of the players in Guild Ball, I think Compound is one of the ones I'd want to be least. You know, he's a human being. He's got the robot hands. I mean, that's going to get awkward. Yeah.
Well, there's a whole 2 minutes of wood getting wood, doesn't it?
I suppose
Will you
so,
quit
yeah. Although he's clearly very strong, so he can lift up his mighty gut, which is even mightier than mine.
I'm saying something. Wait, enough with the biting. Go have a little lay down. Go for a nap.
Doesn't need to move that far, because Silence isn't going anywhere fast, is he? They're just going to lurk near him, provide a bit of kick support.
Lurk.
No, Silence went to some passing.
Okay.
Squawk!
So you're on 5s, which is irritating. Why don't you be on 5s? Because then that makes all of that more difficult.
Hello. Go to sleep, see? I see you stay there and go to sleep. You're not a lapdog.
It's your hyper. It's exciting new visitors. Well, it's not very exciting. Visitors.
No, she goes mental with people anyway. Don't you? Time to get rid of you, I think.
Maybe Silence should have got rid of.
Oh, I don't think this is going to work though, but.
Yeah, good.
You've got to try it. But then if you do get rid of the ball, it might make things easier later on.
I'm not used to having the ball this early, you see. I was forget about how fast Rachel is.
Oh.
She's amazing. I love her.
Mm. It was the other game we had the other day, weren't it? When I didn't see her. Mm. She was hidden behind a building. I just didn't see her.
Oh, yeah.
And all of a sudden, she's just gone, whoosh, scored.
Literally, she was here, so that he didn't...
Couldn't see her. Yeah. No. I completely forgot she was there.
She just kind of went...
Just kind of think, I'm right over here. You can't get me.
No, but especially once you drop the smoke as well. Mm. The free smoke from Flask.
No, she's nippy. Well, same as Midas, say, once he starts racking up his... heroics and mentors.
Yeah, so I said, ugh.
Can you stop licking my slipper, you freak?
Sorry.
Oh, okay.
Do it once, and everyone's all like, you slipper! Yeah, one slipper. Oh, fucking fuck.
It's nice to not be timed, though.
Yeah, no. Couldn't fucking deal with that. I spent influence wrong because I'm a douche. I'm going to do a thing which is very, very integral to the game. Which is going to be moving Mercury a little bit and not doing much else.
That's exactly what I was doing with the bird. It's the time wasting move.
Yeah, yeah. And that's legitimate, I think.
Well, that's the whole avarice and greed thing, isn't it?
Basically, yeah.
Just potter about.
Activation advantages, I believe that they call it in a technical way, and we just go fucking about.
Yeah, playing against them.
I'll waste that point.
Mate, Dustin's Engineers, the Plumbers Guild. Drill Boss D on the forums.
Oh, right. Drill Boss D.
Plumbers Guild. Mario themed, really cool.
Really
good goal that looks like if it falls over, it's going to crush his players. They're really nice. But he uses Avarice and Greed.
Well, are there pictures on the forum?
Yeah,
so go and check that out, people.
Yeah, he uses Avarice and Greed basically just as two extra activations. It's kind of lurking at the back, not doing an awful lot, but it means that everybody else gets to go last, and they're generating influence they're not using, which the rest of the engineers can use to shoot you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's quite nice.
And I think it does work from the fluff in that they're kind of just sneaking around at the back, still affecting the game almost.
Yeah, you kind of got one eye on them, waiting them to do something cool, and they kind of don't, but everyone else does something cool while you're distracted.
But they have the potential, I think. I think especially the big fella, Greed, Avarice, I always get them. Yeah,
Singled out on one
is awesome. And there's a... He's got an early knockdown on about two, I think, as well.
Okay, right, well, Silas is going to start off by...
Embalming. He's balmy.
So he's going to embalm these two because they're
dicks.
Easy to hit.
Yep.
That's not really going to work. So
he's down to one dice, though. Mm-hmm. It costs two, and because it's minus two, he's on one dice plus one difficulty, right? He's below one dice, effectively.
Dice, but the dice difficulty doesn't go up.
Does it not? I thought with the defence,
you get more dice if it's lower, but I don't think you get more dice if it's higher.
I think you're on plus one difficulty. That's the way we were playing it. Because your defence changes. Let's have a look.
Well, I'll see what I roll anyway.
So in the same way...
Flask.
James will give you more Stella, but it's going to cost you 15.
Yeah.
And Mercury. Okay, well, he missed Flask anyway. He's going to
hit He would hit Mercury anyway with the change in stuff. So
let's put you on fire.
They're nice tokens.
Oh, what a light then.
Where'd you get them from?
They're from Broken Egg. It's Kickstarter. Broken Egg.
Yeah, just to have a look if you can see that. I'm trying to get up.
Get out without.
Those are
they're
awesome.
Little 3D perspexy.
Little flames.
Partially see through.
Okay, let's. I'll little go flames. With as well.
What else has he got?
He's got a little poison one as well.
Oh, lovely.
They're cute, right? They're really cool.
Oh, they're really cute.
Yeah, they're really good money. They're for Kickstarter. I think they worked out about £5 for five of each. We've got flames, poison, knockdown, bleed.
Awesome.
And some ones I use as icy sponges. Which
are they from again?
I think it's Broken Egg.
Broken Egg Games. Check them out.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That's awesome. I love that. I like lots of things like that when we play 4K, don't we? We have to have lots of explosion markers.
Yeah, give a bit of colour as well. So they're poisonable. They're quite big, but it means you can see them. You don't forget to.
So it's my activation.
So that was the lobbing. Now he's going to pass.
Lob. He said lob.
Lob. Now he's going to spend the last one to pass. Uh-huh. He's got kick support. Uh-huh. Before I see, he's going to pass to Porpoise.
Yes,
kick. Oh, yes, yeah.
That's four fours.
Wow, Yahtzee. Or Yahtzish.
Chain's like, have you started forcing Porpoise beer? Well, we didn't have to force him.
Suggesting it in a
rough kind of manner. Right,
we're having one. We're not saying that you should, and it would be bad if you didn't. But well,
pass move slash give and go.
Yep.
To shuffle the old man up a little bit.
Okie dokie. Now, what am I going to do, Straw?
Don't ask me, mate. I've no idea what. I've never played with the alchemist, so I wouldn't know. I know what you do with them all the time.
Playing that
bloody arse.
Poison you.
See,
Alchemists is just such a. They're kind of quite an underrated team. I think a lot of people seem to struggle with them, but. They're pretty nice.
When you started off with them, you were a bit, I don't like them. But then all of a sudden, you had a couple of games with them, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
And then you just clicked, and I was sort of thinking, shit the bed.
I think the Alchemists, they haven't got a lot of obvious. Yeah, they can throw stuff, and
it's momentum some of it, generating, they struggle with that.
But I think the key with the Alchemists. You're never going to pick it up in two or three games. You want to play like eight games with them and try everything on their cards to see what it does. Because you look at Heavy Bird and you go, oh, well, he can do all this other stuff. That's way, oh, Clone, that sounds cool. And he's got all the push and he can do this and he can do that. Oh, and Calculus can do poison and all that's cool. And really, if you just do a bit of everything and suddenly you go, everything's useful in a specific moment. And if you know what to use at the right moment, then it becomes...
I found a similar thing with these guys, especially with silence. The easy option is you just chuck your balmy fluid, and then it's kind of actually using shut out and tucked at the right times are nasty. But using it obviously at the wrong time or relying on it as a game plan and then missing. It's kind of putting the pieces together.
But I mean, you'd say use either shut out or tucked on someone. So use tuck so they go last. Obulus then moves them in because he can. Public last room, and then you can just gang rape them. Yeah, or batter them.
Not so much with this team, but
generally,
if you want to do that,
it's options to do, isn't it?
And again, that was the whole Steve Newton trick with him saying you go first with him for influence, punch someone a couple of times, pick up some momentum, and then you got the bonus timed tucked in the shout out.
Yeah,
and it was kind of like I hadn't actually thought of doing that. Silence normally just lurks around the middle or the back somewhere with two influence embalming people, and very rarely does anything else. But using that is nasty.
Mm.
Did it in the next game after listening to the podcast.
Never thought of that.
It was vicious. Yeah.
Never thought of that.
And he was saying, especially against the Brewers, because the Brewers, I think it was Chris Rutter was saying about the same conversation that he likes to go. You like them to go in a certain order because you want extra.
Yeah, I have started to find that with the Brewers. I need.
And then heat one knocked down, and this can happen, and when that happens, this heroic can activate and stuff like that. But then if you can mix around with that, or with any team, if you start. Moving around who can do what when.
But that is the beauty of the game. It is so adaptable.
Mm.
You know, you can just by changing out one player, you change the way your whole team plays, and that's the fun of it.
But also, different people discover different things against different teams. So, you know, and playing the same couple of people over and over and over, you kind of fall into some patterns and ruts and stuff, and then someone else suggests something, you just think, how the hell did I not spot that one?
I mean, I've only ever played the Morticians when I played you.
Yeah.
That's the only sort of when there's all those bloody tournaments, haven't we? And I've never played them.
The first tournament I went to, I played them three times.
Ooh.
And it was nice though, because you're playing against, you think, I know that you can do that, and I know you can do that, and then they do something different that you're not used to doing. And it's like,
I
forgot about that.
I mean, I keep getting fishermen and engineers.
Yeah.
Oh, and bloody Union!
Damn you, Union!
We
hate
Union.
Played against Union once,
Union,
really.
Horrible.
Oh.
I did get battered a bit.
Such bastards.
Oh, bloody Blackheart, I want him to fuck off and die somewhere.
The frustrating thing for me, personally, was I've played them, I've only ever taken my Butchers to tournaments, and you think, Butchers, we're fucking well armed, we'll kill everything, and then you go up against Union, and they dick you in the combat game. And you're like, hang on a minute, this makes no sense at all. How are they killing me?
Because you're shit.
I'm shit, apparently. Yeah.
Goes without saying, doesn't it?
But Blackheart's a total dick.
Oh.
Even Obulus thinks Blackheart's a dick.
Yeah. So, blind works against that.
You don't want to blind anyone, that's just me.
Oh, yeah, but it might be about the only
one. Still waiting to hear back from Andy Scott, see if he wants to trade them figures. So, I went through all my zombie side stuff that he's listed, and I think I can get, there's about 10 figures I can give him.
Right, okay. So,
but four of them are
four.
I even tried to get my missus into Zombicide by saying that we could get Big Bang figures. Because she's obsessed with that programme.
Yeah.
Sprint 8 today.
And she didn't fall for the bait.
Damn it! And then we've had a lot of fun playing the Black Plague version at the moment.
Yeah, we played them. One of my mates said Zombicide, we played that. I only played it once, it was really good.
It's such a fun game.
Playing it with people rather than against people makes a nice
change. Yeah.
I like it as a co-op, it's fun. We've got a mate who doesn't play co-op games. Really irritating.
He hates it.
I love a good co-op game. Yeah. Co-op games are great.
I haven't played much of them, but...
I'm waiting for the new Labyrinth game from River Horse.
Yeah. Oh, and the new film that they're saying?
They're going to reboot Labyrinth.
It's not a reboot. They're saying it's a sequel.
Is it going to be based on a graphic novel, I wonder?
I do not know. Was there a graphic novel?
It was a graphic novel when Toby was growing up. Yeah. I never read it, but it was it was an anime, as I recall, wasn't it? Anime manga style.
I do not know.
It'd be weird if the guy that played Toby, who does a lot of that stuff, made it, because he'd be making a film about his character.
Yeah, that would be weird.
Growing up when he's grown up.
Yeah. Well, Terry Jones still being
confusing.
Picked up. I don't know if his dad Brian's still about.
Henson.
Brian Froud.
Oh, Froud. Mm.
But it will be Disney Wank, won't it? Because it's Disney Wank, because they own it now. So, point to Sprint, just so, well, I suppose we should play the game at some point.
Someone's saying that, they're listing.
Just
like,
we should play
just, if you know.
We can play the game.
They're saying, list a book that you've read which was written before you were born, blah, blah, blah. And someone was going on about like the Arthur Conan Doyle books and all of that. And then they got to the Edgar Rice Burroughs. I'm like, I'm just going to follow this one because I know where this is going. And they're going, oh, John Carter Miles, blah, blah, blah. I said, just stop right there. Ignore the film, it's a bag of shit. The books, however, awesome.
See, this may get me thrown out of the house. I actually quite like that.
No! See,
there's a trick to watching those kind of films. Watch it.
Beer.
Yeah, a beer. Watch it, probably not a beer, as a 7-year-old. Imagine yourself as a little kid. Yeah. Now, when I watched that film, 7-year-old me would have loved that film.
Yeah.
I just would have blown my mind. And that's kind of the age that a lot of people think read those kind of books. That's when I was getting into like sci-fi fantasy. I read a lot of like Douglas Hill. That's what got me into kind of reading and sci-fi and geekhood and stuff.
To the geeks!
Possibly that was the fork in the road. I would have absolutely loved that film. So I don't watch it as a critical adult. I watch it as... seven years of me getting into Star Wars and all that kind of stuff, similar age. Same when I watch Star Wars now, I have to watch it as a kid. If I watch it as an adult who's also seen The Family Guy, just watching it, just thinking, God, this is awful. But watch it as a kid in that mindset. Fantastic.
Oh, what was it? Dogma. Right, I watched Dogma the other day. And I like it, right?
Two of my least favourite actors.
He doesn't like it, but I like it, right? But when you actually examine what goes on, it makes no sense. Because, so they're going to go through and they're going to go to heaven, right? You've seen it
it a long time ago.
So the two angels, they can go through this thing and be redeemed, so then when they become human again and die, they can go to heaven, right? Except because they've effectively said that God is definitely real and the Bible definitely happened. And so that meant, yes, there are all these plagues, yes, Noah happened. So, like, God's a total dick. Like, if that really was the case, and God made that happen, that's a dick move, right? But now it's all, oh, but it's God, it's lovely. Well, no, still did all that dick stuff.
Yeah,
and then when they do finally...
still did all that dick stuff!
And then
there's whole books written about the dick stuff they did, to be fair.
And then at the end, they decide that you can't kill them at this point, but you can kill them at that point, but if they're in a human body, then they'll die, but they'll have souls, so they go to hell because they've done bad stuff. So essentially... two protagonists go to hell because they die as humans.
Because God.
Because
he's a dick.
And you're like, oh, that's kind of sad now. It's not now a little quirky satire with some funny people and a guy who's a bit of a stoner. Now it's like a real downer movie.
Yeah, that's the whole message.
Maybe it is. Anyway, sorry, we went on many side paths. we digest.
After all that, he's forgotten that he's going to blind me.
No.
Oh,
I'm
going to
blind these two because I can sprint 8. Yeah. Fortunately, it's got a range of 8, but no, because I put the middle there, so it's fine. So, firstly, on bone saw, this is my point to do it. Fours. Bum, ba, da, bum. No.
That's all right.
And Cosset. On Cosette.
Cosset.
Yeah, I know, I'm being a dick. Blind dead. I've got blind. It goes away anyway, it's not a sustain. Ha ha! And now she's there. Yeah, it's Cosset, it's Fillet as well.
Frankie,
fuck you, the world,
down.
It's Fillet. It's not Fillet, it's fucking Fillet. I was a butcher in real life.
She's been blind.
Fuck you.
Frankie! Down! Frankie!
I shouldn't have worn the orange top, it's confusion.
Get down!
Come
here.
No,
this?
It's not Tender Reserve.
What's this? Tender Reserve?
Tender Reserve.
Hello. Right. So now you're coming after me, are you?
Minus four
attack as well.
Don't nip, because I'll throw you out.
Okay,
minus
four.
Hello. Ow!
No!
No!
I believe so, yeah.
Charger!
Oh, claw to the face.
Probably damage.
Stop it!
Yeah, only a couple of days. I'm trying to get some momentum going for next turn.
Ah, you can score from there!
Try.
Yeah! Will!
You
dirty little whore!
It's all the dodges and stuff that frustrate me.
I set this really cunning plan the other day and then ended up. I actually worked out how close he needed to get to the goal.
Oops!
Right, so he's going to need to get.
Stop it!
Counter-charge range of him.
Good girl.
But you can get there purely by dodges and stuff. Then you're alright.
I don't think you can, though.
Oh, is this only if they move it to its own, is it?
Yeah, it's when you enter the advance.
Or so if you puppet master him away from the goal.
Yeah, then you wouldn't get it. But then would I have enough movement to get there? Because if you charge, we bounce off here, and you'd end up kind of no man's land. Master you forward. Run out of influence. I only have 5, see? Or we wait till next turn and score next turn.
Oh, you haven't got momentum, so you can't do that.
Well, I'd have to bounce off somebody, so I could charge, bounce off. Wouldn't have enough to. If I had one more, I could then puppet master him in, and then.
Well, I was thinking you could base move, puppet master yourself for another base move. Spend your last point to take a shot on goal, but you need to generate momentum.
And also, I'd get counter charge because I need to get to back here.
Yeah.
And Puppet Master's still.
Unless you're engaging him, and this because he won't get the charge, but you will be at minus to shoot.
He's already on one dice. So, yeah, he's going to dodge. Even if he sprints, Puppet Master smack you once. It's a bit iffy. I do
actually really enjoy when I'm playing against an opponent discussing what they and I can do. Like, yes, I'm going to tell you what I can do.
Not on the clock so much.
No. But it's interesting to discuss what could happen from any variant.
I think it helps as a learning thing as well.
Yeah.
Because it's instead of just doing something, doing it wrong, you're going, oh, I wish I'd kind of thought about that a bit more. But it's bouncing ideas off each other.
Yeah. Good evening, Mr. Bond.
Well, that would definitely generate some momentum. If nothing else. So you are blinding. Right, okay, so.
Look, I didn't go calculus and hemlock, that would have been wrong. That is a dick move. I'm actually glad that although I picked up the Alchemists before the Erratas all kicked in, I'm glad I didn't play Hemlock with them, because I would have totally relied on Hemlock, like all of the time.
Yeah, one of friends playing the other day, I forgot about Decimate's one inch melee.
Oh, gutted!
That was a beautiful moment. whole plan.
She's still good though.
She's still pretty nasty.
So if we get up to there, we can slap her a few times, generate some momentum. She's only 1 inch, isn't she?
Mm-hmm.
So,
Opulus will
just...
in a combination of dodging and walking, basically.
Yeah.
Get to within two, but not within one. That might be poison.
I like the way you move the ball up. I always forget to move the ball up, and then Straw whinges about it.
But also,
you didn't move the ball.
So one to pass. So, so she's 4-1, isn't she?
She is 4-1. I'm going to do nothing about it.
You got some comments on it. Momentum starved. Right, okay, so 4-1.
Boom.
So two roll hits. That'll be a momentous dodge.
There we go.
Make sure we actually so we generate momentum. So that's the first one. Six damage. Just to remind me that I actually need to dodge back into.
I do that.
Second one. Three hits this time. That'll be momentous 2 damage.
Oh, I'm actually writing shit down, aren't I? Sorry.
The last one, this is where he misses everything.
We live in hope.
Oh, look at that. He's too soon.
Joke.
What a bloody idiot. So he basically he misses, and he's got one left to not do an awful lot with. He just punts it into space, I suppose.
You know what? Because I'm super nice, you could easily be in that place and still be in 2 inches, so you can have used your dodge earlier in the turn. Because that's how good I am.
Of course.
You could have been there, and you're still in plenty of range, but we're now. Aren't I? Right, I want the audience at home to know that that is the game-changing moment. So if he wins, it's totally because of that. Not because...
No take backs. We'll just rewind. Let's take a photo. We can rewind.
We can play from exactly this moment. Yeah.
See, this is the problem. This is what I do. I end up doing all this kind of weird stuff, and then I forget something really obvious. And then it's usually my pet goes, you've just done that. Which is great when you're playing in a chilled out game, but in a tournament, on the clock.
Yeah.
I'm not sure whether it helps me focus my mind or whether...
You just forget all of the things you could have done.
The game completely. Okay, cool. Well, if you'll allow me to do
I'm not a total dick. Despite what he says. Mean.
Right. Well, he's probably going to miss the kick now.
Hopefully.
So we'll learn what bonus time. Awesome. Your bonus time to kick. Oh, I can't aim this. He gets it. So we'll do that. That's a trick. See, I would use my 4 inches. However, this is a limited edition. 3.6 inch.
Oh, is it?
Measuring tool.
Yeah, they did say, didn't they?
Cock up!
No, limited edition.
So that would be worth a lot of money.
Yeah, I agree.
Never, probably. But,
cock up!
Right.
What a bunch of
your opponent wants to measure 4 inches.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there we go. So he'll go, and that's that last point spent. And he'll bounce up with that 4. Give me the 2.
Okay, okay. Indeed. Yes. And so on and so forth.
Now we're one take back in debt now.
Right.
Come on, give me some tactics. So you've watched enough games of this. You must have some cunning plans.
She only has one tactic. It's bite your face.
Come on, down yet.
Come on.
Vitriol is going to charge. Populous. I now have an 11-inch charge range, which is this is a 13-inch stick. So I'm poking on there to charge
it to base contact.
To B to B, because otherwise I'm because he's not going to be able to hit you.
Because he's not used unpredictable movement.
Narp.
Which we used.
So that's 2 for the charge. Are you're not playing any cards, are you?
I'm not.
It doesn't mean you don't have them. Let's
check which cards I've got. If only I had some handy
little stand.
Stand.
Yeah.
In orange, of course.
In orange.
Well, I don't know what colour do I get, because I've got Benny boards in kind of greyish, the blinding yellow.
Clearly, you go Battlehammer Orange all the way.
All the way.
All the way.
I'll just replace everything.
Right, so I'm on fours and one.
Fours and one.
Points a bit.
Well, that's a bit poo.
Ooh.
That's three hits after the armour.
Three. That's about five damage.
No, you're not in cover or anything yet.
Sex noise or zombie?
My sex
zombie noise. Sex noise.
Oh! Now you're talking.
Is she dodge pushing?
Momentous dodge McPush. Get nice up and close to you. This is again, it's little things like that. How long did it take me to realise you could dodge towards people?
And push people towards you as
Yeah. Instead of pushing them away.
That's alright, because if you push me, I'll be further away.
And it's all the whole, and it does say push away or push not away.
I think the thing is, because I was using Morticians, and Blast is a push directly away.
Yeah.
So it's kind of used to the whole push directly away, push directly away, push directly away. And then all of a sudden, it's like people are pushing you when you're getting closer. It's like,
and even that's right, Ghast isn't there. That's what I'm sitting there going.
You'd normally have that for Ghast now. You've got Bone Saw.
No, I still use Mist now.
I think most people would leave out Cosset and Ghast in.
Yeah.
But I quite like Cosset.
Swings and roundabouts, isn't it?
Because of her speed.
Oh, and that's momentum.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to have another hit with my last point, which will be base 5, needing 4s and 1. That's shit. So nothing happens. Nothing. Tra-la-la. Oh, I see
that's
we
about that poop. Earlier on. Pretty poop.
Okay. So you won't know because you were on the train. You did.
He was on the train.
Oh, you were on the train.
Hogson's train.
I was thinking of something else. They did an honest truck. Because we were talking about Screen Junkies earlier on, they did a Labyrinth honest trailer, didn't they? About a week ago.
I watched something. They did. There was one of those, like, everything wrong with Labyrinth. It must just be a short video where they just say nothing.
Yeah, I agree. Harvey, best film ever. And David Bowie's crotch is supposed to be like that. There was being an interview with Jim Henson saying, yes, it's supposed to be like that because it's the whole sexual awakening and everything. That's what it's about. Of course he's got a massive bulge. Idiots.
It's a subtle film. It's on many levels.
Ooh. I love it.
Still got it on VHS.
Oh,
the last
nice.
Time I watched it actually was on VHS, complete with Fuzzy Nine.
Oh, happy days.
Okay, so
there are lots of like pause lines on Jennifer Connelly's scenes.
Oh.
I wonder if Paul Bettany watches that. Or does he go back and watch Labyrinth and be like, oh yeah, I'm tapping that.
I just want to do his heroic plays because I've never managed to actually play it off.
Don't put it off. Let alone you have to put it back on.
I've tried to pretend that every day of the week.
Just engross myself in reading this character traits here. Interesting. Okay, so potentially I could then charge through her.
Yeah, and
yep.
Hit
punch
from the other side.
Back.
Yeah. Bitch.
Thank
I'm
you.
Get attacked by the dog
come
again.
Here.
Let's see if this will work.
I might be able to get the charge off on you though, because you're going to be within six. That's going to be the issue you're going to have. Yeah,
no!
Be within six and be able to charge
stop
it.
Stop it!
My counter charge will happen before your charge starts. Sorry, dude. Well, I mean, I say that, I'm actually not. Obviously.
You're not sorry at all.
Right. I'm sorry in precisely zero ways. I feel bad that you can't do it, because it would have been a cool thing to do.
It would have been a cool thing to do, but that's why you have compound.
Yeah. He's a greasy lover.
I'm not fortunately my blind little girl wandering round at the back.
Is that you trying to eat my foot?
Hey!
Yeah, she does that sometimes.
Quit that!
Alright.
Pay me attention. I'm the centre of
attention. She wears big, comfy slippers, so she rips them to bits. And then she realises the rest of us just wear normal socks.
Yeah.
And we end up with no toes.
Sorry, my rabbit does the same thing.
Alright.
Her teeth are big.
Oi, get down. Come on, down.
She hasn't quite sussed friendly nibbling.
No.
Alright, so, okay, that plan isn't going to work then.
Sorry, dude.
That's long. Am I going to survive his counter attack? He's got lots of.
He has got plenty of pushes, a tackle push on 2. He's got a knockdown on 4.
Knockdown on 4. Is he attack 6?
He's attack 5.
Attack 5, so. That's a lot of dice.
Yeah, I would do the tackle push on 2, but Mux, you can charge as much or as little.
Yeah, so
that's another thing. When we're talking about pushes and stuff like that, you can choose the amount of push you do or don't use.
Mm.
So, like, you can drop, like, say, lob bomb is the classic one, and you just think everyone goes like that. Well, actually, no, I don't want everyone to go like that.
Well, yeah, his unexpected arrival is quite good. I'll just push you out of the way.
But leave you there so I can tackle you or whatever I want to do.
It's equals 3. I'm not going to. Even if he got that off, he's not going to be close enough to push.
Anyway, I think I chose compound knowing you were playing a footballing team.
I shouldn't have revealed my intentions via Twitter.
Dun dun dun! To be fair, my other choice was Catalyst and no, because Catalyst. There was an interesting.
I think he's got uses, I think it's just.
Yeah. There was a thing on the forums a while ago about, like, Catalyst. Now they've changed him from 2s to 3-1 or whatever it was. But it was like, he still doesn't do enough for me. Like, yeah, he's tougher, but he doesn't really do anything.
Yeah.
He doesn't, you know, he just, yeah. I don't
like being that close to vitriol.
Oh, she'll fuck you up, bitch.
I know. Right, okay, well, maybe we'll just
fuck you
charge
the fuck up.
Calculus.
A little bit harsh.
Maybe.
Harsh.
Yeah, maybe.
Charge Calculus.
We can do punk.
It's got a little bit chilly.
Right, okay, so what I'm going to do, Bonesaw.
Bonesaw is ready! That was a little Spider-Man moment for you.
So he's going to charge. Vitriol's 2-inch man, isn't she?
Vitriol's 2.
Cactus only 1.
Cactus is 1, poisoned. But you are now poisoned. But on the plus side, you're not on fire. I actually think fire's worse.
Poison kind of doesn't do anything bad to you, so you forget about it.
Yeah, and then eventually by turn 3 or 4, you're like, oh, fuck, I'm on this man.
Okay, so.
Get off
the
bloody rulebook, you shit!
Yep.
So we lose
the dice. Oh dear.
Not for you, that's signed.
I've got momentum now. Do I? Don't I? Tra-la-la. No, I want to keep it. I want it.
You want it?
Oh, I want it because I'm a dirty bitch. 4 to 1.
What
are
you doing,
Mankina?
1, 2.
Wow, that was
good.
Probably rubbish.
Good? I mean, no. No, I mean good.
Okay, we didn't get enough to do what you wanted to do, so we'll get rid of that one because of bloody armour.
Sugar bam!
So, he will just take the momentous dodge.
Momentum.
Okay, just push it back an inch. Right, is it okay? So they're basically going hide, wasn't there?
Vitriol. Morning!
Did you want the ball?
Well, she always wants the ball. You know what?
She's a bitch. No, no, I won't do that.
You good?
Yep.
Okay, I will.
Something else I could have done, actually, but.
Have you got points to do it with?
Do you know, I want the momentum.
Yeah, sure. I just don't mind.
Yeah, let's move that.
Okay. I am going to activate compound because he's my last person who can do out. And he's just going to shuffle to make sure he's a bit forward, but kind of still in range of the goal token.
Dun dun dun!
Right, so it's just
on a blind one. Come at me, bruh! Yeah.
So, Cossack goes.
I know what I'd really like if Heavy Burden wasn't once a turn, that'd be great.
Try and lure Vitriol.
No.
resists her tender charms. Right.
She's not that kind of girl.
She's not, unfortunately.
Okay, so everything goes now, right?
I don't think a bitch likes anyone, to be fair.
She's a bitch.
Psycho!
So that goes back to you. You take
blind back.
Thank you. He takes a point from fire, which is ironic. Yes. You'd think he'd be able to get rid of his own fire, wouldn't you?
He takes 2 points from poison.
Yep, and that is all. That is all.
Good time again.
Right. So blind for you, bird for you, and then you're on +3, I'm on +1.
One.
Oh.
Oh.
Which is equal, yeah. So roll again. Bugger.
One again.
Same again. That's not.
Come on, guys. Jesus Christ. One again.
But four for me! Boom! What are the chances of that?
If you want to chew on anything.
Chew on this dice!
You can be relegated.
Okay, so.
That was always the fates, obviously, but when you get me that, we'll give it in the first time.
So that goes away. Then I'm on the whole thinging of stuffing.
What?
Thinging of stuffing.
Pitcher tackles the ball, scores. There we go.
Yeah, job done.
Not necessarily. But probably, yeah. Okay, so she'll get 4 points, because she can have 4 points. And to be fair, Frankie. She always gets 4 points. Hey. She can always do something.
Come here.
Whether it be scoring,
the plan was to charge her, get unexpected arrival, basically, and shove everybody. Mm-hmm. So shove her in the way of him, potentially do a counter charge, and then shove her right over here, so she has to. Wouldn't be able to just attack him straight off the bat.
Get his upside down one and an extra.
Cool, sorry. What are you doing? You're going to dribble and let my hand.
No, I'm just going to nip it when you least expect it. Dum 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 dum.
Dum 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 dum
dum. Oi!
She gets a bit like that, doesn't she? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oi!
That's you. What are you gonna do?
Sis! Get lager!
You might have that just in
case. Sit!
For you, because he can always do something.
You prefer my run. Midas can always do something, don't
Because he's my.
He didn't actually steal anything, did he?
No.
Bugger, right?
Which sometimes I forgot about him actually, just kind of sitting over there in the shadow of that room.
Yeah, which
just like hunching up.
Sometimes I don't mind if he doesn't see it. If it's not something I really, really wanted, then it's like, well, then I don't steal anything, and then I can still use him for stuff.
It's like Christmas engineers. They go to minefield.
Yeah.
Why? Go to. No.
Okay, you're set.
I'm cock lock ready to rock, mate. Something equally cool that the kids say these days. Their coolness.
You wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Did I take 2 damage and fire?
It's 1 damage from his fire.
But from the embalming fluid, that's
yeah,
2 damage.
One. No, and he does 1. Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, 1 and then. Because his does 2, doesn't it?
Why is calculus on 2 damage? I might have boxed it up. Vitriol should be on 2 damage because she was the one who got hit
by
me.
No, he slapped. He did slap her.
Oh, right, okay.
And then he dodged back. And,
yeah.
And then
yeah,
you
yeah.
pushed him further back.
Yeah. Sorry, just confused. Yeah. Sorry, I'm a dumbass.
It's not just your arse that's dumb. It's the rest of you.
It's my thighs as well. Dumb thighs. Doesn't really have quite the same ring to it, does it? Ring.
Ring.
Okay, that's cool. Not necessarily. Ooh. Hopefully, yes, but not necessarily. Okay, so I'm going to activate Vitriol. No surprise there. Mm-hmm. She is gonna.
All over?
I think she's going to move first. If I can just put my incher.
Handy having them, isn't
it? Arp.
I don't wonder how we ever played without them.
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. Until we got these little widgets. Mm.
See, because I've just had this one before.
Yeah.
That was quite handy. So yeah, it's just been able to put it down and just work out where you need to get it.
So if I move to about there, I'm still in both of yours.
He's only left one, but she wasn't within 1 inch of him anyway, was she? If you go through there, yeah, you can be going through
his. I would have to be within one of his to be able to tackle the ball, if nothing else. Just shifting the ball around about there.
Although you're two, though, aren't you? So you don't need to be within one of him.
But if I leave you, you get part and blow, and you might then dodge out of the way.
But I still can't dodge an opponent, though.
Can
only damage, tackle, or knockdown.
Oh.
And he doesn't have a knockdown.
But he does that, and he can't. Can he do his counter play?
No.
Oh well, in that case, let's toughy fudge it up.
So worst, he'd probably slap you with a bit of damage as you run past.
Cool. We'll have that then.
Because you wouldn't have the ball at that point.
No. So I'm gonna move to there-ish.
It's his point blade you need to worry about.
Oh yeah. But I'm not worried about that yet because I'm still within two.
Gonna dodge out.
Hopefully.
When you end your advance within his melee, he could. Stand next to you.
Yeah, that's fine. If you want to do that, I've moved within his melee. It's an advance, so you can then.
I thought it was only if you end in a.
Well, I've ended my advance, so he can now unpredictably move.
He can unpredictably move
towards
to
or away
from just dodging out.
Mm.
Potentially.
We can do, but then you'll have used your unpredictable move right at the end of the turn.
It gives you one less dice. So.
You're still in two, so you can stay there.
So it's just gonna.
Banana!
Okay.
The base.
Just to keep the buttery biscuit base.
Banana!
I'm gonna have an hit on. Bonesaw.
That's not much. No, it's not quite. About as close as you could possibly get without actually.
What a douche. So I'm on base 5.
Again, that's little details like that. Someone who was good would think, oh, if I just shove him back a bit, he's in cover. I'm not even looking at that.
Mm. So base 5, minus 1 because I'm ganged up. Needing 4's 1.
4.
4's nothing.
No armour for him.
That'll be 3.
Yeah, he's 5's when he's activated.
Which will be an. It's got to be a non-momentous tackle, really, hasn't it? Because we'd be mad not to.
Mate!
Thank you for the ball. I will have another hit. Oopsie. And my base 4 is 1. Well, 4 is nothing even. 1, 2, 3.
Sprung back into life.
Which will be a momentous push dodge. So we'll have a. I'll dodge myself. Away from you, and I'll dodge you into there-ish. Three little skulls. That's my little ball. Now I've got one hit left. Well, I've got two influence points, but one hit before I start shooting gold.
And you might as well hit.
And I'll hit on Obulus. I'm base 5 now. Need 4's 1. 1, 2, 3, which is 2, which is a momentous push dodge. Crack a thing.
What are we talking about push dodges being nasty?
Yeah. So you will go to there.
Relying on the dice to roll poorly was obviously.
I will then go
to. I don't really need that.
I'm then within range. I will then take a shot on goal with my last point of influence, and I'll use a point of momentum to shoot, a point of momentum to bonus time it, because, you know, my life.
Get 5 dice now.
5 dice, need an 4. I need more. Kick it in the goal. You'll go in the goal. Kick it in the goal.
Goal, something or other.
I love Vitriol. She's such a bitch.
Bitch.
I used to think that Mist was better. Now I think that.
Who are you?
So she's revenged. We have got vengeance tokens, haven't we? Boom.
I don't even remember buying those.
I just ordered them actually.
I don't even remember.
I thought I'd better have them to actually like play the game rather than just the really old cards with me.
Yeah.
And written errata's and stuff on. Right, so.
And you keep an eye on kicking out the bowl whilst I use the convenience. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen.
It's not like he's going to bleed and cheat, is he?
Here is proof that God loves us and wants us to be happy. Benjamin Franklin.
This is a guy who created America, people. It must be right.
Today's message brought to you.
Brought to you by Stella.
Right, okay, so we're going to...
End up with somebody. Well, it must almighty. It must, isn't it? It's as long as it's not betrayal. Alright, so yellow's his direction. Follow one. So basically, this is gonna drop just nice, the for her. Essentially, right next to us. Okay. Should wait for him to return. Nah.
Well, we're gonna be going for gold this time?
Tempted to just kind of partly charge her just to
fuck her
while she's vengeance.
Oh god, yeah, especially while Cossett's there.
Cossett's there, Obelus is there.
Oh, that would just be mercy. I think you could get Bird out there as well. Yeah. It's a pain in the arse, that one. I keep forgetting about his mass thing.
If I can do... So if he was confident, the problem is his calculus is just that one armour. Such a pain. I always forget she's got armour.
Yeah.
And there's a bonus punch to her. You can push her back on his first attack, kind of in the way. Then charge her, and then you can't do counter-attack because she stood in the way.
There.
But it relies getting all four hits on her.
Oh.
Because of one armor, he needs three hits. So he needs to confidence him up first.
Yeah.
So that may help.
What strange as evil magic has occurred? I went out that way and I came back in this way.
You went round the back of the camera, you twat.
Don't tell them.
Well, they know. They're not stupid,
was it? This was a moment of
pain.
I mean.
It's such a good moment, the words.
The just, words!
There's not even any words to describe.
It's not even words to describe how good this moment was. It was a bloody visual...
Poo, is all I can say.
Visual masterpiece.
Poo. Visual masterpiece it was. Yeah.
Of course, if everything takes off, now we hopefully can start getting some money and shit, we can actually...
Hopefully we don't get the shit. We just get the money.
We can actually go then do the BBC editing.
Yeah, yeah. We'll do an editing course and we can edit.
Wow.
Yeah.
The joy of the missus working at the BBC.
Yeah. So... She got the ball.
I still can't believe people actually want to give us money. Mad.
Well,
I like the fact they give us toys.
So
I prefer that.
2-6.
I prefer having toys.
So then he could dodge.
So I do like them counters.
They're cool, aren't they?
Then really he doesn't like. Actually end in advance.
No, that's correct.
How much momentum did you come out of all that with? None.
No, oh, one from the goal. Yeah, which I forgot to add.
No, you didn't want to use it for anything.
Good.
God. I know the Yggdrasil goals are gorgeous, flip things are gorgeous, but I'm sorry, I like our cheap ass production one.
I like that one. You can see it from
you
a distance.
Sell them. I mean, how work intensive they are to make.
Well, you have
very
to cut some in
say
hours.
Very.
Hours.
Days,
he's gluttonous and masked, isn't he?
He's a big fat buddy.
Buddy, buddy, buddy!
He's a fatty, buddy.
There he is.
Get his massive base.
Oh, his massive base!
He needs one hit then to dodge to get some momentum to shoot. Okay.
Bonesaw's trousers have come out particularly well.
Fucking awesome, aren't they?
Yeah. I mean, I love the whole thing,
I love the figure.
Come out very well.
That's because of him. That's why I now want to try and get hold of all my morticians in the resin, because they're just so much better.
He went together okay in metal. Resin's just light.
I love it. Especially
it feels weird.
All my bloody morticians keep breaking.
Yeah, up until I got, well, like I say, I got that, still got that in resin.
Because I love you.
You do.
I think, oh, you're venin as well, haven't I, coming in resin?
Sorry,
don't like it that much.
But I think until he got it, I was like, oh, resin, it feels light, it feels cheap.
Yeah, but
actually, when
you
get it, the details are made awesome.
Yeah, I suppose if you're kind of a paintery type person as well. Mm. Right.
It makes no difference to me once it's like, I can't see it, it blurs anyway.
Okay, so Obelus, I think, is the new
She hasn't got unpleasant movement or anything,
has
she?
No, it's just Midas, isn't it?
Oh, you've got a redonk early knockdown, haven't you?
Oh, yes, as well!
Yeah, you get plus four net hits from Vengeance.
Yeah.
So that's...
You could use that.
Yeah.
Okay, so, well, he'll charge. Is she fours or fives?
She's on fives, no armour.
Dun dun dun!
Ah, but I can spend... Yeah, you charging?
Because you can do your...
I can do defensive stance if you're charging.
By confidence, put myself up.
Mm-hmm. Dun dun dun!
Charge.
And then I'll spend a point of defense
charging you, actually.
Yeah, you might just wander in, might you?
So we get 10 dice just for wandering in.
Hmm?
With a reroll.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. You don't get dice, you get net hits.
Well, yeah, it's better. 4 net hits, which is better, yeah. So you're just
going
to
float.
Oh, I love the occasional white feather in there.
Mm-hmm. Nice, isn't it?
It's gorgeous.
Also, when you damage it, you can. It's easy to repaint that.
Good point.
You heard it here first.
Yeah.
Tips from the master. Awesome.
Yeah, it's easier to repaint.
Yeah. Way.
All right. So defensive stancing.
If you're charging, but you're not. So I.
Oh yeah, you can't. Can you?
I can't defensive stance. I can counter attack, but even though I can. So meh. Well,
so fives. Confidently reload it.
I wish I had one of these every time I play. It's just like a little bod to run around and keep an eye on stuff. Oh no, I don't want it now.
One more.
Yeah, get some air, bitch. Oh, brilliant.
Okay, so he then gets...
Thank you, my minion.
Four hits.
You shall not be killed this month. Perhaps next month.
Thank you, my...
Okay, so we can wrap. We get three original hits, which is a bit rubbish. And net four.
So seven. If my maths are not awful,
so we will choose the knockdown.
Oh!
Oh, Frankie!
It literally is a picture of a guy being knocked down.
Frankie,
so, and then if we do. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and then.
That's a thing I never noticed either.
That's not a momentous.
Because you're playing a two player game, one side's facing you, the other side's facing me. So it doesn't matter, you don't have to worry about them being like that, because you just put them like that.
Yeah, that's quite good.
Awesome.
Yeah, they thought of everything. They're good. Good tankers. Mm. Right, so, and then we'll just do the one-inch dodge just to generate some momentum.
Mm-hmm.
Because that will just a point of damage.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so now we will slapper again, Rosh is on the floor.
Fours.
Three, so that's two momentous damage.
Come on, you girl, you've been nice.
Two.
Oh, yeah.
Take your damage, bitch.
Yeah, yeah.
Take it off your girl.
But just
kick it on the floor. Two hits.
Another two?
That's a... Wait, how many wounds has she got in?
She's now on 10.
I'm trying to build up momentum, so I'll go for the dodge.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one. I'll slap it again. That's reverse it. Two damage again. Point of momentum. Right, that's him done.
Okay.
Actually, which is completely not what I meant to do. I meant to spend the last point to confidence out.
Don't think she's going to need it.
What's she on? Now, eight.
Yeah.
It's still nice.
So.
It's nice to get wraps with Cosset. It doesn't happen very often.
No, it
but
doesn't.
But when it does, it's lovely.
Yeah, you just sit there and go, oh yeah!
Again, that's why Catalyst was good. Hit them on twos, everything was a wrap.
Yeah.
Now, not so much. Maybe Catalyst needs like a special spectator rule. Where if you don't pick him, you get like an extra bonus. It sort of seems quite sad. Just
can you imagine him sitting?
It's like he gets a lot of training done though. Running,
running on
can you imagine him sitting in the dugout going,
big compound coming on.
Hey, pick me again, am I?
I actually want him to be the veteran for this team.
Mm.
So he's because the whole background is like his heart's going and he's I think they actually say his organs are liquefying.
Bigger but weaker.
Well, so he's on 3-1 now, so go back to twos, but be like Hulk smash, total just knockdowns on one, you know.
Mm.
It's got a lot of health as well, so...
Catalyst smash!
I think it's the problem is, he's 3-1 and he's got a lot of health, but he's got gluttonous mass.
Yeah, so and gluttonous mass has
gluttonous mass.
Oh, isn't that Fangtooth's got it?
Awesome. Ah, Fangtooth's a dick. He's a wonderful dick.
Oh, hello!
You bunch of pervs.
He said, is not got.
Totes.
I just, the problem with Fangtooth, same with Casket, is you put them somewhere central and then I just forget about Foul Odor and just go, I can do that. Oh, I can't do that.
But it's just such a, just a single one piece figure. It's just a nice bloody figure.
Yeah.
It really is. Mm. And we've all voted for it.
Yeah, I voted for that. Did
you?
Yay!
This video will probably go out after that's happened. However, if it hasn't yet happened, go to beastofwar.com. Check out their website. They've got voting for best stuff of the year. They've got like an award ceremony. It's really cool. And you can vote for Guild Ball stuff. And what I love you've got the big Archaon and all these big models of resin, and you've got Fangtooth, a one piece, just stick it on
one
the base.
One piece, short, fat guy.
Which is awesome!
But it is a great model.
And it's simplicity, that's the thing. Yeah. It's like, especially that Archaon, it's massive, but it's just, I don't even know what to look at when I'm looking at it. There's just too much stuff going on.
I think the only other thing I voted for on that was something for Blood Rage.
Yeah, Blood Rage was best board game.
Yeah. That's an awesome little game. Awesome game. Love it. Mm.
Anyway, I've got to do some things, haven't I?
Let's see. Do
the funky gibbon.
I was just saying, we haven't had a sing song yet. It's just it's bored, this is.
Remember a time. Don't worry about that.
We haven't had a sing song, I've only had one beer.
Sorry, Master.
Kill him!
Oh, I started watching Doctor Who last night, Pargy.
Doctor Who?
The catching up, and I.
I've seen the latest series.
Smith
was alright, actually.
And
Peter
Capaldi.
Peter
Capaldi.
Just he looked too young for me.
He was better after he got on.
That sounded so wrong.
Doctor Who should be like a kindly uncle.
Yeah.
The problem is, I was sort of Sylvester McCoy era. Doctor Who.
I love Sylvester McCoy. It's only later I've watched back and realised how nasty he was.
Yeah, he was Do you know who I always thought would make a great Doctor Who was Adrian Edmondson?
Oh, good lord.
Because especially now. When he does serious acting, he's really good.
Yeah, especially now. Yeah. Oh, and we watched that that thing you kept telling me and Jane to watch that, and then there were one.
Yeah.
That was really clever.
Was that right?
Really good. Really enjoyed that.
Good, I'm glad.
I was going to recommend Jessica Jones as well, because she said about watching that.
Oh, yeah.
She's hot as hell, though.
Yeah.
Haven't seen it yet, though.
I'll give her lots of love.
I'm about two-thirds of the way through.
David Tennant's supposed to be really nasty in that,
he is, really. But he's a bit like, you kind of see him and you think, oh, it's Doctor Who, and then, oh, no, that's really not that nice guy.
He's Doctor Who.
But he's so nasty in, like, a casual way. Mm. It's just kind of just like, it's just not a thing.
Yeah.
It's quite disarming.
Well, I hate to say this, I am actually looking forward to the mini X-Files thing we've got coming up.
Oh yeah, Channel 5 I think.
Yeah, Channel 5. I can actually watch it. Whoa.
Netflix.
Was it already on Netflix? Is it?
No, like with Jessica Jones and stuff like that, it's Netflix. And anything that's on Sky Daredevil. Type stuff is.
We can't afford to watch stuff like that.
Well, yeah.
We work for the Battle Hammer. The Battle Hammer are very, very bad at paying me, aren't you, Parker?
Yep.
Which we're going to have to keep playing out for all these bleeding tournaments we keep going to.
So with the boys.
That's why I didn't go to school, Dick. Because I just didn't have the money.
But you're going to the big one though, aren't you? That's going to be awesome.
I've been to BritCon a few times for different things. So I kind of had that already budgeted and planned in, and I had permission for that. So I just shunted BritCon permission basically across dimensions.
Nice. It's going to be one hell of a fucking weekend. It's going to be awesome.
So there was a couple of 2 days this year that I was tempted by, but that was the one. It was just like, I'm going to do that.
We were going to go, because they were going to have it in February, but then we caught up with Jay and Chris at Doncaster, and they said, we're not doing it now, just keep your eyes open. I'm like, okay, and then literally got home, it was like, they're now doing another one. So I turned around and said to Parky and the other Muppets that we go with, I said, look, do you fancy going to this one? Oh, yeah, because we had so much fun when we went up there, didn't we?
Even BritCon, that was one of the first, I think they only had two or three before that. And just the whole community thing
It was amazing.
Such a laugh.
We would never, as Parker said so many times before, we'd never ever go to a tournament for anything else that we play. But for some reason, this just works. And up there, it was absolutely fantastic. We had so much fun, met so many nice people, played so many fantastic games, that we thought, oh, sorry, we'll have to do it again. So we managed to get the hotel all sorted. And then Lee turned around and said, you guys going to... I'm like, yeah, he goes, I'm driving. I'm like, oh, good, awesome. good for you, you bugger. He went, no, you missed the point. I'm like, what? He goes, do you want a lift?
Yeah.
I'm like,
that's a bit of a trek for you guys.
Hold on, you've got to come from Sheringham down to us and then all the way up. He goes, yeah, I prefer to have an hour in the car on my own than have the whole journey on my own. I'm like, well...
Yeah, Stockport's actually an hour and a half from me, direct. Pretty good. I realised it was that close. It was like, that's like, how am I going to get there? So many miles. It's like a direct train.
Well, are you based off of
Milton Keynes.
Milton Keynes.
So it's a direct train up.
Oh, it's
not,
four.
It's not a cheap train, but
four and a half hours for us.
Yeah,
Lobbing fire there.
Four and a half. It's fine until you get to Sheffield, but Sheffield's like Ely. You go into it and then you come back out, and that completely freaked us. And then from Sheffield to Stockport, it's all like bloody great tunnels and cliffs. Not happy about that.
Your bones are on fire!
Is that two damage as well, isn't it?
It is two damage as well.
I think the mistake was we went to the gaming place before we went to the hotel. And we got in there and Jay went, get yourselves a drink, lads! And we're like, what?
Yeah.
There's a bar like this big. And we're like, oh no.
And we drank a lot of cider.
Oh, we drank a hell of a lot of cider that night.
Well, it's really
is that him done now?
Well, he's him done.
He's lost fire. We exchanged fire.
He's going to... Just the same move.
Showboating.
I don't know how you got through that Saturday, mate.
I don't.
I've never seen anyone look so ill. But in saying that, at Doncaster, we lost Jason.
Yeah. Is he actually turned up?
Yeah, we found him.
We found him.
Eventually,
it's like, I don't know how I got back
to
the hotel.
He hasn't a clue how. Brilliant.
He doesn't know how. I'm like, shit, the bed. Lovely bloke. Have a lot of time for Jason.
So, Cossack, do you want to do what you do best?
Charge!
Failing to kill somebody and not living up to your potential. And then probably being stuck with ball.
That's what she does for me all the bleeding time. Promises so much and then just fails to deliver.
Oh, I can't do anything about it because I'm not dead.
No, you can't.
Exactly.
She will rip you to freaking... You've only got 8 hits left, haven't you?
8, yeah.
Oh, good lord.
Does she want to get rid of the ball first, though? Oh. She doesn't do kicking a lot. Gonna have to get rid of it at some point. Right, okay, so she's gonna bonus time pass to Bonesaw.
Oh. Come on, Cossacks!
She is gonna play something.
Ooh. Bitch! She never manages
to.
Doesn't do it very often, though.
That's because somehow she always ends up near the bloody goal when I'm using her.
Yeah, it's always free charges, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's his charge then?
He has got a base. Well, he's got a charge of 7 inches and a 2-inch melee.
He's totally charging.
Frankie, get down. Get down. Oh, come here.
Behind him.
Come here.
That's what she said.
That's what.
Just glad it's a girl. No baby dog winking.
Sit up here. Watch the game. Watch the game.
At least
watch the game.
Actually, I'm still not safe from him charging because he's got 2-inch melee.
That doesn't appear to be watching the game. You're a lovely little dog, aren't you? Tom, get rid of you. Take back Snetton. Get rid of you. What do you mean, dog? What do you mean, no? Go on. Good girl. Don't fight people.
Okay, he's probably slightly better placed over here. So we'll use the momentum to take those various.
Come here.
I almost wish I had Catalyst for this moment.
Oh, that was really hard.
No, I really don't
know. That was the one she generated. Yeah, so she spent one. I had 4. She spent one.
Generated one.
Put it back, and then he spent it.
What's this?
Right, now she'll charge.
Ouchie.
She's going to
This is going to
be about it.
She will cut herself first.
Yes!
Not that we are, you know, advocating self-harm. Only from the purposes of crazy people in this game.
Or drinking.
That's kind of a self-harm.
Okay.
Or excuse.
Having to work with Parker. That's mentally self-harming.
That's more like an inward self-harm, isn't it, really?
Okay, so, count four for the charge, and then she's got a boss.
Ooh. Oh, crikey. Oh, you roll
fours.
Oh, come on.
Not
there. Oh, that's...
Yeah. Oh, that's actually
better than I thought.
That's not that bad, actually. That's pretty good. See, this is why I need everything on the front as well. Roll on season two cards.
Mm. Yeah, but are they going to sting us for them?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh, better not be. Two, three, four. 6, 7, 8. That is a wrap.
Wrap round!
What are you doing, Doc?
Frankie!
Oh, yeah, she's got a really long play.
She's run away from the bird.
Frankie, come here!
So she's going to do 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Is it lager? 6.
So she does 3 momentous
6.
And 1 non momentous.
Glory vein. 1, 2, 3.
Or she could do 5 non momentous.
Touch you. 1, 8. So.
I'll do 5 non-momentous.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Once you caught fish alive. Why did you let it go? Because.
So what do I need to do? 3 to kill her.
3 to kill her.
So I need 4 hits.
Wasn't that a. Oh, you've got like.
Yeah.
That was a free charge and now you're spending a hit.
1, 2, 3.
That'll be the 4.
3 momentous damage.
Boom.
Victual goes down, like a sack of the proverbial potatoes.
She...
Then I spend a big fat stack of cards.
8. Bone, so she might become a mate bone, so I think.
Knockdown goes, because she's not there anymore.
So she'll come and mate him to get rid of all these fairies.
Oh, oh, that's just dirty!
I now play vengeance upon her.
Oh, that's just not very fairy.
And I play... Man down. Man down. Everyone gets plus one armour to the end of the turn. Which isn't the biggest of deals, but could potentially have...
Could stop the old bounce and stuff, they can't.
Yeah. That's that done. Right. So.
Okay, so...
That's my activation.
It's so nice for me actually watching the Morticians in play and not having to worry about what I'm doing with them. It's really refreshing.
The problem is they are one of those teams that they can do such cool stuff. That you kind of think, I should be doing cool stuff. I shouldn't just be beating that person up.
Yeah.
So I always think, like, I want to take rage, but at the same time, I should be doing funky things. I shouldn't be just punching people and generating momentum. Mm. But he does it so well.
I refuse to take him, just for the hell of it.
He's a gorgeous model, though. It's just that.
I know. I love the version of him with the captain, where he's got the long coat. Mm. That's really nice, isn't it?
But then again, if you take captain rage, you can't take normal rage. Which is such a gorgeous model.
Oh, I can't remember who it was. It might have been Gilbert tonight saying you should have rage, mascot rage, captain rage, and rage.
Hello. You're being a gym.
Mascot rage would just be his hat that just inspires everybody just to be awesome. See, the problem with rage in a mortician team is that you just constantly want to be able to confidence him and puppet master him, and you can't. But he just doubles up so well with Fangtooth.
Because he ignores his rough ground, doesn't he?
Or even Casket. He sets people up to be Casket, because he can just hang around their Casket quite happily.
What are you doing?
But then I just think maybe I should just take a union team if I'm going to deal with that.
Dirty bastards. Let you come round, so we knew you weren't going to bring a whole union team. What sort of person is the full union team?
Well, the problem is I don't like the Blackheart model, so I can't use it because I don't like the model. And if I use Captain Rage, I can't use Rage.
But Captain Rage model looks
I need to buy more models.
Yeah.
And he is. That's what it is. He's going to be hard, isn't he?
Tricky when you've got to buy more toys.
Okay, so do I do that? I think I'm going to have to go with that and see what happens. But then that seed then becomes yours, and then I won't have enough to do out with.
Out? Do out with?
Aye. The problem I've got is that my list is engaged by Miss, so I can't charge out.
That's a shame, isn't it?
Mm, it is.
If only I'd noticed that as well. I probably would have done something slightly different. But...
what are you doing, girl? What are you doing?
Medal. Let's do a sprint and a hit, because I'll be so quick.
You could punch him and because you're 1 inch melee, aren't you? Yeah. So you move in and then.
I'm pretty sure you've got like a tackle, dodge damage, and there's nothing else you can do if I move out of combat.
If you run away from mist, one damage is about it. You can't trip it off his stick or anything.
Right. My bloody one broke again, didn't it?
You missed, yeah.
Twice now.
See, mine is, he's still got the tab attached to his foot, and the tab is green stuffed into the base. And I've done the same with Green as well, because he's not got a huge joint.
Yeah.
And I'm too scared to buy snakeskin. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do. She may not have like a vine coming up her leg.
You can just push her back, and her cloak will actually touch the ground as well. Yeah. So that's what I did. With him now, I've had to tilt him forward, so he's got his staff in the ground as well.
Yeah, maybe I'll do something up Snickman's boot.
I'm
not sure.
Okay, so. Oi, oi. If I can get those ones off of me mate, he's saying that he's got the mist and resin as well. Right. Please give me it.
Still quite a small joint to snap.
Yeah. What the hell do you think you are playing, young lady?
I'm going to go...
Closing face!
I think
we're
something really stupid. Fucking why not, right?
Stop it.
It's a learning experience.
Yeah. Right, okay. So I'm just going to spend a couple of momentum to activate my heroic play, which gives me plus two move.
What's Jason want?
Then I'm going to activate my legendary, because I know that Obulus is already gone, so I know that I can keep those points for something. Probably not
going
even useful.
Probably just going first.
Then that gives me a move.
He's doing something
of
cunning,
10.
Stop distracting me.
Frankie, get down! Me? Parky,
yes,
Jason, got a message just saying, just have had your Wrath of Kings battle report a shout on the Cool Mini or Not Facebook page.
Hey, that's good.
Well done. But I did a mature warning as well, so I don't want you guys getting in trouble again.
Nice.
What the fuck? Frankie, come on!
So that was a point of influence advice spent, which is a point of momentum gained, up to three. So I will now spend a point to hit you.
He's going to punch
Bonesaw in the face, but I generate another point of momentum for that.
So, shall I do something?
You can count that, but you can't.
Well, it looks like everyone's telling Gilborg.
So I was distracted.
Go big or go home. That's exactly what I said.
Is it a charge?
It wasn't a charge, because I couldn't charge out of your engagement by move. So you get a point and blow of that here. On the fives.
I've got to
four.
So rubbish. 2 hits,
so point of damage. So exactly what a diamond thing mean then? More prizes?
It means the prizes that we won't win will be bigger.
Oh, even better! So that means the spoon will be a big wooden spoon instead of just one little...
Yeah, it could be.
That'd be nice. We need a bigger spoon on that wall of death, don't we?
So now I'm hitting bones, so it's a basic hit.
There's an attack four, so I'm not entirely sure what he's going to do with that counter attack.
Oh, he's got a fucking extra point of armor, hasn't he?
No, I've got plus two move, because that's how I got him.
Yeah, but you got your man down.
Oh, I do!
Yay!
So I'm on fours, no armor at the moment, you haven't activated yet. One, two, three, four. Come on, baby, say you love me!
Five, six, seven times!
It's me. Right, fine. It's us. Non-momentum tackle, because you got a... you know what? I've done it now. No, should have cloned, and then you would have had... Then I would have generated momentum, and then you would have wasted your thing.
Yeah, because clone... Is clone one or two?
Clone's three.
Three.
But... Okay. I roll four. But I've done the tackle.
Have you got... Oh, you've got a counter second across there.
So what are you doing? Five's one armor.
Five's one now. Five's one. Yeah.
Boom!
So...
Point of momentum worth spending there.
I always fucking end up going, I'm going to do that because you can, it's really important that
I think it's more... I know, he could have... Particularly if he got three hits, it's unlikely, but he could have tackled the ball back, which would have then really screwed your plan.
Totally. Plan? I mean, totally got a plan. Get the ball and you not have it, that's pretty much my plan.
So has Midas got anything left now?
Yeah, he's got two. I'll move him over here. I do apologise. Because he had four. I spent one to sprint. Mm-hmm. I spent one to attack. Both of which generated me a point of momentum. The actual tackle didn't generate momentum.
Yeah.
But I can now generate one momentum per influence spent because I'm activating my legendary.
You generate one from the attack, though, don't you? Anyway. Did you do legendary at the start?
I did legendary at the start. So the sprint generates one. The attack generates one. But I didn't generate one from hitting because it was a tackle, which doesn't generate momentum. So I can.
The attack generates it, not the.
Yeah. So. Now. I'm gonna. I'm gonna I've got two left. I'm gonna try and hit Bonesaw again. Which generates me another point of momentum, which I'm going to spend to bonus time it. Putting me on my base 6 plus 1, making it 7 dice needing 4s, no armour. One, two, three. Isn't what I wanted, but still. Better than kicking the minge.
And that generates another momentum anyway.
Yeah, so that generates more momentum because I did it. And if I can do something cool with it, then.
Hello!
I'm a wizard! Fuck you all in the bum holes! I'm gonna do.
I feel there's a certain amount of private humour.
Heavy burden. It's from the.
It's the wizard we're doing.
The wizard I do in. What's it called? Zombie Side Play. My wizard is.
Wizard's
is not
Bondry.
Very loosely based on Brian Blessed.
It's a bloody.
Oh, I'm a wizard!
It's like Brian Blessed with his balls in a clamp.
Yes!
It's horrible.
Alakazam! And stuff.
I shall cast a spell! Why don't you shut the fuck up and roll some dice?
I'm going to do heavy burden on that guy.
I don't want to do that.
Because I can do that through a hit, which generates me a point of momentum.
Nasty man.
Minus four, minus four, move, minus two. It's. No, it's
character blade.
Then I'm going to attempt to pass the ball to Catalyst.